mathematicians, it's Justin again. Mia and I are at the movie theater to catch a film. I saw this sign earlier today that said movie tickets were on sale. Check it out. If Mia and I get in the line on the right, tickets will be 1/3 of the regular price. And if we get in the line on the left, tickets will be 1/4 of the regular price. I don't know about you, but I like to save money when I can, and the smaller the fraction, the less I'll have to pay compared to the regular price. How can we figure out which fraction is the smallest? Well, we could compare these two benchmark numbers like 0, 1/2, or 1 to decide. Or we could think about the size of each fraction's pieces and how they compare. Thinking about benchmarks and the size of fraction pieces is a great start, but what if the fractions aren't as easy to compare? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to analyze a set of fractions to determine which are larger or smaller. You'll also be able to compare fractions using different strategies. Have your guide and notes ready? Because it's showtime! I need to make a decision about our tickets. We know the fractions 1/3 and 1/4 represent the part of the whole price. What do you notice about the numerators of these fractions? They're both 1. Since the numerators are the same, let's check each denominator. Remember, the denominator tells us how many equal parts the whole is divided into. By comparing the size of the pieces, we can figure out which fraction is smaller. A whole split into fourths has more pieces than a whole split into thirds. The more pieces there are, the smaller each piece gets. That means 1/4 is less than 1/3. So the tickets that are 1/4 of the full price cost the least. Decision made! Line on the left. Oh, but Mia's right. We can't watch a movie without snacks. Time to grab some popcorn! We can order popcorn buckets that are either 3/4 full or 5/6 full. Kind of wish they were one whole full, but which one has more popcorn? Well, we could compare these fractions to benchmark numbers like 0, 1/2, or 1, but 3/4 and 5/6 are both closer to 1. Fortunately, there's another strategy we can use to find out which fraction is the closest to 1. What if we could always work with fractions that shared the same denominators? Like comparing 2/10 and 9/10. When the denominators are the same, it makes it a lot easier to compare the fractions because the size of each piece is the same. The fraction with the greater numerator would be the bigger fraction. But we can't just pick a random number for our denominators. We need to create equivalent fractions so they still represent the same value. Like how 5/6 is equivalent to 10/12 and 15/18. Pause here to record two more equivalent fractions for 3/4. Three fourths is also equivalent to 6/8 and 9/12. So do any of these fractions share the same denominator? Ooh, they both have a denominator of 12, 10/12 and 9/12. Since 10/12 is equivalent to 5/6 and 9/12 is equivalent to 3/4, we found a common denominator or a shared multiple between these two fractions. And that means we've made them even easier to compare. 10/12 is greater than 9/12, which means 5/6 is greater than 3/4. I'd like the bucket that's 5/6 full, please. Listing out equivalent fractions is just one way to find a common denominator. Sodas here come in cups that are either 2/3 full or 3/5 full. They are really cheaping out on us. We'll start by listing some multiples of each denominator. Some multiples of 3 are 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, and 18. Pause the video here to list out the first 6 multiples of 5. The first 6 multiples of 5 are 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and 30. Do you notice any multiples in common between these lists? They have 15 in common. That means each fraction has an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 15, making them easier to compare. Now we just need to change 2/3 and 3/5 to 15ths. To turn thirds into 15ths, we multiply by 5. 3 times 5 equals 15. Then we multiply the numerator by the same amount to make an equivalent fraction. 2 times 5 is 10, so 2/3 is equivalent to 10/15. Pause the video here to find an equivalent fraction to 3/5 with a denominator of 15. So, what did you multiply both the denominator and numerator by? Remember to check the denominator first. Since 5 times 3 equals 15, you'll need to multiply both the numerator and denominator by 3 for an equivalent fraction of 9/15. Since 10/15 is more than 9/15, that means that the soda that is 2/3 full will have more than the soda that is 3/5 full. Now that we've got all our snacks, let's compare some fractions that show how full each theater is. Theater A is 2/6 full, and theater B is 3/10 full. We need to find a common denominator between these two fractions. What should we do first? We need to list some multiples to find which one they have in common. 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, and 10, 20, 30. Oh, they have 30 in common. Now we need to figure out how many 30ths each fraction is equivalent to. We could do this by figuring out what each denominator is multiplied by to equal 30. What do we multiply 6 by to equal 30? 5. So we'll multiply the numerator by 5 as well. That gives us the equivalent fraction 10/30. How do we turn tenths into 30ths? Multiply by 3. So 10 times 3 equals 30, and 3 times 3 equals 9 for an equivalent fraction of 9/30. 10/30 is more than 9/30, so theater A has more people in it than theater B. Theater C is 4/6 full, and theater D is 5/9 full. Theater E is 2/10 full, and theater F is 11/14 full. Use a strategy that works best for you to compare these fractions. You might choose to compare to benchmark numbers like 0, 1/2, or 1, draw a model to visualize the fractions, use your understanding of the size of the pieces of each fraction, or find common denominators and rewrite the fractions. Feel free to use the same strategy for both sets or a different strategy depending on what you know about the fractions. Pause here to compare the sets of fractions in your guided notes. For theater C and theater D, using the common denominator of 18 gives us 12/18 and 10/18, meaning 4/6 is greater than 5/9. For theaters E and F, I noticed that 2/10 is pretty close to 0. 11/14 is more than half, so 11/14 is greater than 2/10. You might have used different strategies to find your answers, and that's totally okay. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that Mia and I just can't resist the largest bucket of popcorn? Well, now you know that there are several strategies you can use to compare fractions. You know that the bigger the denominator, the smaller each piece will be. You also know that fractions can be compared to benchmark numbers with visual models, or by creating equivalent fractions with common denominators. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice comparing fractions with unlike denominators. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time! Hey, hey.